This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Christian Science Monitor CSM is an international news organization that delivers global coverage via its website, weekly magazine, daily news briefing, email newsletters, Amazon Kindle subscription, and mobile site. It was started in 1908 by Mary Baker Eddy, the founder of The Church of Christ, Scientist as of 2011. The print circulation was 75,052. The Monitor is a newspaper that covers international and United States current events. The paper includes a daily religious feature on the Home Forum page, but states the publication is not a platform for evangelizing. In 2008, the Monitor discontinued its daily print version to focus on web-based publishing, replacing its daily print edition with a weekly news magazine with an international focus since late 2013. The editor-in-chief has been Marshall Ingwersen. Contents 1. Concept and inception. 2. Later developments. 3. Notable reporting. 4. Modernization. 5. Radio and television. 6. References. 7. Further reading. 8. External links. Concept and inception. Despite its name, the Monitor does not claim to be a religious-themed paper, and says it does not promote the doctrine of its patron church. However, at its founder Eddy's request, a daily religious article has appeared in every issue of the Monitor. Eddy also required the inclusion of Christian Science in the paper's name, over initial opposition by some of her advisors who thought the religious reference might repel a secular audience. The Monitor's inception was, in part, a response by Eddy to the journalism of her day, which relentlessly covered the sensations and scandals surrounding her new religion with varying degrees of accuracy. In addition, Joseph Pulitzer's New York World was consistently critical of Eddy, and this, along with a derogatory article in McClure's, furthered Eddy's decision to found her own media outlet. Eddy also saw a vital need to counteract the fear often spread by media reporting. Looking over the newspapers of the day, one naturally reflects that it is dangerous to live, so loaded with disease seems the very air these descriptions carry. Fears to many minds, to be depicted in some future time upon the body a periodical of our own will counteract to some extent this public nuisance, for through our paper, at the price at which we shall issue it, we shall be able to reach many homes with healing, purifying thought. Eddy declared that the Monitor's mission should be to injure no man, but to bless all mankind. Later developments. The Monitor was for several decades published in broadsheet form, but in 1975 switched to tabloid format. The paper's overall circulation has ranged widely, from a peak of over 223,000 in 1970, to just under 56,000 shortly before the suspension of the daily print edition in 2009, partially in response to declining circulation and the struggle to earn a profit. The church's directors and the manager of the Christian Science Publishing Society were purportedly forced to plan cutbacks and closures later denied, which led in 1989 to the mass protest resignations by its chief editor Kay Fanning and ASNE president and former editor of the Anchorage Daily News, managing editor David Annable, associate editor David Winder, and several other newsroom staff. These developments also presaged administrative moves to scale back the print news newspaper in favor of expansions into radio, a magazine, shortwave broadcasting, and television. Expenses, however, rapidly outpaced revenues, contradicting predictions by church directors on the brink of bankruptcy. The board was forced to close the broadcast programs in 1992. The paper has been known for avoiding sensationalism, producing a distinctive brand of non-hysterical journalism. In 1997, The Washington Report on Middle East Affairs, a publication critical of United States policy in the Middle East, praised the Monitor for its objective and informative coverage of Islam and the Middle East. In 2016, Christian Science Monitor Washington Bureau Chief Dave Cook irrevocably barred the entire Daily Caller from his newsmaker breakfasts because columnist Evan Garr mocked him as acting like Congressman Sandy Levin's press secretary by trying to impede his questioning. When the veteran Democrat was a guest, Garr asked Levin to define the difference between a Democrat and socialist, since other prominent Democrats had recently refused to answer the same question. Notable reporting. Monitor staff have been the recipients of 7 Pulitzer Prizes, the most recent in 2002-1950, Pulitzer Prize for International Reporting, Edmund Stevens, for his series of 43 articles written over a 3-year residence in Moscow entitled, This is Russia Uncensored, 1967, Pulitzer Prize for International Reporting, R. John Hughes, for his thorough reporting of Indonesia's attempted transition to the New Order in 1965 and the purge that followed in 1965-66-1968, Pulitzer Prize for National Reporting, Howard James, for his series of articles Crisis in the Courts 1969, Pulitzer Prize for National Reporting, Robert Kahn, for his inquiry into the future of our national parks and the methods that may help to preserve them 1978, Pulitzer Prize Special Citations and Awards, Journalism, Richard Strout, for distinguished commentary from Washington over many years as staff correspondent for the Christian Science Monitor and contributor to The New Republic 1996, Pulitzer Prize for International Reporting, David Rode, for his persistent on-site reporting of the slaughter of thousands of Bosnian Muslims in the Srebrenica genocide 2002, Pulitzer Prize for editorial cartooning, Clay Bennett in April 2003, after being provided documents by a former Iraqi general, several news organizations including The Monitor reported that George Galloway was accused by a U.S. Senate committee led by Norm Coleman of personally profiting from corruption within the United Nations Oil for Food program. The Monitor investigated the matter, concluding that the documents were almost certainly forgeries, and, in response to a lawsuit by Galloway, apologized in court in 2006. Jill Carroll, a freelance reporter for The Monitor, was kidnapped in Baghdad, and released safely after 82 days. Although Carroll was initially a freelancer, the paper worked tirelessly for her release, even hiring her as a staff writer shortly after her abduction to ensure that she had financial benefits. According to Bergenheim, beginning in August 2006, The Monitor published an account of Carol's kidnapping and subsequent release, with first-person reporting from Carol and others involved. Modernization. The print edition continued to struggle for readership, and, in 2004, faced a renewed mandate from the church to earn a profit subsequently. The Monitor began relying more on the internet as an integral part of its business model. The Monitor was one of the first newspapers to put its text online in 1996. And was also one of the first to launch a PDF edition in 2001. It was also an early pioneer of RSS feeds in 2005. Richard Bergenheim, a Christian Science practitioner, was named the new editor shortly before his death in 2008. Bergenheim was replaced by a veteran Boston Globe editor and former Monitor reporter John Yema in October 2008, citing losses of US$189 million per year versus US$125 million in annual revenue. The Monitor announced that it would cease printing daily and instead print weekly editions starting in April 2009. The last daily print edition was published on March 27, 2009. The Monitor continues to offer daily news online on its website and via email. Yema stated that the move to go digital was made because they recognized that the Monitor's reach would be greater online than in print. He has also stated that in the next 5 years the Monitor would work to increase their online readership fivefold, from 5 million page views to 25 million, as the paper has turned its attention to online storytelling. It has been breaking ground with multimedia projects like Little Bill Clinton, a narrative serial following a year in the life of a young refugee. The weekly magazine follows on from the Monitor's London edition, also a weekly, launched in 1960, and the weekly World edition, which replaced the London edition in 1974. Radio and television. Monitor Radio was a radio service produced by the Church of Christ Scientist between 1984 and 1997. It featured several one-hour news broadcasts a day, as well as top-of-the-hour news bulletins. The service was widely heard on public radio stations throughout the United States. The Monitor later launched an international broadcast over shortwave radio, called the World Service of the Christian Science Monitor. Weekdays were news-led, but weekend schedules were exclusively dedicated to religious programming. That service ceased operations on June 28, 1997. In 1986, the Monitor started producing a current affairs television series, The Christian Science Monitor Reports, which was distributed via syndication to television stations across the United States in 1988. The Christian Science Monitor Reports won a Peabody Award for a series of reports on Islamic fundamentalism that same year. The program was cancelled and the Monitor created a daily television program, World Monitor, anchored by former NBC correspondent John Hart, which was initially shown on the Discovery Channel in 1991. World Monitor moved to the Monitor Channel, a 24-hour news and information channel. The only religious programming on the channel was a 5-minute Christian Science program early each morning in 1992. After 11 months on the air, the service was shut down amid huge financial losses. References. Carat archived copy at website March 17, 2013. Audit Bureau of Circulations. Carat ABCD about the Monitor. The Christian Science Monitor retrieved February 5, 2007. Carat Alex Beam June 9, 2005. Appealing to a higher authority. The Boston Globe. Carrot, the Pulitzer Prizes, 1969 winners,
Pulitzer October 14, 1968, retrieved April 19, 2010.
The Christian Science Monitor retrieved January 30, 2013.
Boston Portal Christian Science Monitor official website about the Monitor. Christian Science Church puts Monitor radio up for sale,
April 28, 1997. Monitor radio goes dark at end of this week,
June 23, 1997. Christian Science Monitor going mostly online,
PJ Network video interview with editor John Yema,
November 17, 2008.
VE Christian Science Publishing Society Journal Sentinel Herald Quarterly Monitor VE Major English Language Current Affairs and Culture Magazines.
Australia Australian Book Review Griffith Review Minjin The Monthly New Internationalist Australia News Weekly Overland Quadrant Southerly Bangladesh Dhaka Courier Forum The Star Belgium The Bulletin E, Sharp U Observer.
Canada Alberta Views Canadian Dimension Literary Review of Canada Maclean's Maisonneuve Paras This Magazine The Tai The Walrus China Beijing Review Ethiopia Capital Ethiopia Ethiopian Review Hong Kong Asiaweek Asia Sentinel.
India Frontline India Today Open Outlook Tehelka The Week Ireland 4th The Phoenix Village Israel The Jerusalem Report New Zealand Investigate New Zealand Listener North
Herald Newsline South Africa Amandla Syria Forward Magazine United Kingdom General The Big Issue The Drought The Economist FT Magazine The Guardian Weekly The Middle East in London Monocle New African New Internationalist The Oldie Private Eye The Sunday Times Magazine The Week Intellectual London Review of Books New Left Review Variant The Times Literary Supplement Political New Statesman Prospect The Spectator Intersex Standpoint United States General The Atlantic The Christian Science Monitor
Foreign Policy Harper's Magazine Newsweek New York The New Yorker The New York Times Magazine Salon Slate Time U.S. News
Political The American Conservative The American Interest The American Prospect The American Spectator Foreign Affairs Human Events Mother Jones The Nation The National Interest National Journal National Review The New Republic The Progressive Reason The Weekly Standard See also News Magazine
VE Current White House James S. Brady Press Briefing Room Seating Chart Row Podium 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 N B
C News Wall Street Journal Agence France Press Foreign Pool Bloomberg BNA Washington Examiner
Talk Radio News Service Fox News CBS Radio News USA Today MSNBC Time Yahoo News Dallas Morning News CBS News Bloomberg McClatchy Washington Times NY Daily News Salem Radio Roll Call APN PRAURN
The Hill Hearst, SF Kron, Balt Sun Media News, Daily Beast CBN ABC News Washington Post Politico Fox News Radio NY Post Christian Sci Monitor BBC, Boston Globe Reuters NY Times Tribune VOA RealClear Politics SiriusXM Scripps, BuzzFeed
CNN AP Radio ABC News Radio National Journal Chicago Sun-Times, Al Jazeera Dow Jones Financial Times, The Guardian The seating chart as of March 25, 2015 White House Correspondents Association